his, okay, in the previous class, we just completed up to year wherein we had seen Muni was very happy, pleased with the foreigner because he stayed back and he is standing, stayed beside him and he was speaking to him, isn't it, for a long time. While nobody else made made such an attempt of staying back and speaking to the old man like this. So he was feeling happy for the foreigner. That is why he said over here, hardly people used to stop. He said that those who stopped to ask for a piece of tobacco. Now let us continue. But I seldom have it. Tobacco is not what is used to be at one time, and I have given up chewing. So he's saying, but I said, I rarely have that, what tobacco, where people used to stop near him and ask for tobacco, and he used to rarely have tobacco. He says, tobacco is not what is used to be at one time. So it can't be used at one time, can't consume it one time. And I have given up chewing, and I too have left chewing. So where you need tobacco for chewing the pan, isn't it? So for that you need tobacco. So he says, or simply tobacco with betel nuts and all, they chew people, right? So that is what has been spoken over here. So just chewing I have left out. That is what he says. I cannot afford it nowadays. So he says, I left chewing because I can't afford nowadays, Muni says. Noting the other's interest in his speech, Muni felt encouraged to ask, how many children have you? So when he was speaking all these things, you know, he liked his way of speaking. Whose way? Muni's way of speaking. Because the foreigner felt like after the end of every word, it was like getting a kick. So that is why he was listening very carefully over here, the foreigner. So noting that the foreigner's interest, Muni was encouraged and he was going on asking. So he raised a question. He asked a question. How many children have you? He asked the foreigner. How many children you have? He asked in Tamil. Muni asked the foreigner. With appropriate gestures with his hands. So this was asked with gestures. So with actions with his hands, Muni asked this question. Realizing that a question was being asked, the red man replied, I had 100. Which encouraged Muni to go into details. Okay, so understanding with this, the foreigner understood that he is asking a question. So when a question is raised, anybody can understand, isn't it? It's a question. So on this, the foreigner said, a hundred, he answered. So when encouraged Muni to go into details, I said 100, which encouraged Muni to go into details. So when the foreigner said 100, this encouraged Muni to go into details. So Muni felt interesting in this. So he wanted to know when he said 100, through action he said 100. How many of your children are boys and how many girls? So the question asked by Muni over here was, how many children you have? So he felt when the foreigner said 100, foreigner spoke 100 over here in terms of money, right? So here now Muni is feeling that he is speaking regarding his children. So he is asking how many are boys and how many are girls. That is what Muni is asking him. Where are they? Is your daughter married? Is it difficult to find a son-in-law in your country also? So all these type of questions Muni asked the foreigner. So where are your children? So daughters are married. So like how in India all the things carry on, isn't it? So social things he started asking the foreigner. In answer to these questions, the red man dashed his hands into his pocket and brought forth his wallet in order to take immediate advantage of the bearish trend in the market. He flourished a 100-rupee currency note and said, well, this is what I meant. Okay, so in answer, so a foreigner was very excited about it. So he felt that this one is agreeing to it, right? So he just put his hand in his pocket and brought out his wallet from his purse he brought out. Just to take immediate advantage of the bearish, of this rough trend in the market. That's a rough trend, isn't it? To show the note and purchase the thing. So he just brought out that 100 rupees. 100 rupees in those days, it was a big note. Now if you see 100 rupees, no importance is given to that 100 rupee note, right? So now to impress people, you have to show something like 2000 or 500 note and all like that. Something if you show only 500 also, hardly they get impressed. So those days it was something like this. When 100 rupee note was shown, people get impressed and they will accept the deal. So that is why he had roughly shown the trend of the market. He had shown removing the 100 rupee note. He flourished a 100 rupee currency note and said, well, this is what I meant and this is what I meant, he told Muni. So the old man now realized that some financial element was entering their talk. So now when he had shown that note, he understood that something he was speaking in regards to money. So he peered closely at the currency note, the like of which he had never seen in his life. He knew the 5 and 10 by their colors, although always in other people's hands, while his own earning at any time was in coppers and nickels. Okay. So over here you can see he was just looking it very closely because he had never seen a 100 rupee note. He had never in his life seen a 100 rupee note. But he knew that it was a 100 rupee note, but he had never seen. He had always seen. He knew only these notes, 5 rupee and 10 rupee. Isn't it? By their colors he knew 5 rupee note, 10 rupee note, only that. Although always in other people's. That too he had seen in other people's hand, not in his own hand. While his own, whatever he earned, his own earning, whatever he earned at any time in his life, the earnings of his, wasn't only in coppers and nickels, in coins. That is what is being mentioned. So his earnings were always in coins, not in notes. So what was this man flourishing the note for? Perhaps asking for change. So why is he showing that note? Maybe this man was asking for a change. This is what now Muni was feeling over here. He laughed to himself at the notion of anyone coming to him for changing a 1,000 or 10,000 rupee notes. So he just laughed. If somebody stops over there and asking him for a change of a 1,000 or 10,000 rupee note, wherein he in his life had not seen all these notes, right? So that is why he was just imagining about it and he just laughed at it. He said with a grin, ask our village headman who is also a money lender. He can change even a lakh of rupees in gold sovereigns if you prefer it that way. He thinks nobody knows, but dig the floor of his puja room and your head will reel at the sight of the hoard. So this is what he says. So he said with a grin, means with a smile, he said, ask our village men. So when he had shown this 100 rupee note, he felt, Muni felt over here, maybe he is asking for a, when the foreigner had shown that 100 rupee note, Muni felt that he might be asking for a change of 100 rupees. So he, straightforward, he said, ask our village headman, you ask our headman from the village, who is a money lender. So he can change even a lakh of rupees, he can even change a lakh of rupees in gold sovereigns. So he can change it into gold sovereigns. So anyways, you can get a change from him. If you prefer it that way, so if you really want a change, you can do it like that. This is what Muni is telling the foreigner. He thinks nobody knows. So who thinks? The money lender. Money lender thinks that nobody knows. But dig the floor of his puja room and your head will reel at the sight of the hoard. So he says, if you really dig the floor of his puja room. Whose puja room? The puja room of the headman. Okay, the money lender. Puja room, if you dig, your head will reel. Your head will go round and round. That is what reel, right? At the sight of the hoard, looking at the hidden fund. So seeing the hidden fund, you will really faint. That is what he is trying to speak over here. The man disguises himself in rags just to mislead the public. And this man disguises means wearing a mask or changing to some other form, right? So he wear all rags. So he wears his outfit, he wears whatever clothes he wear, that is always in a rag. He'll be always in the money lender. He's just doing like that just to fool people, mislead the public, mislead in the sense fool the people that he is not a rich man at all, he is a pauper. He want to show that. That is why he always wears rags. That is what Muni says away. Talk to the headman yourself because he goes mad at the sight of me. So he says, you can speak to the headman directly. He is asking the foreigner. You go speak to the headman by yourself because he don't like me at all. So if he sees, he really go crazy at the sight of me. So he dislike me. This is what he says. Who? The headman. That is the money lender. Someone took away his pumpkins with the creeper and he, for some reason, thinks it was me and my goats. That's why I never let my goats be seen anywhere near the farms. His eyes traveled to his goats, nosing about, attempting to wrest nutrition from minute greenery, peeping out of rock and dry earth. So this is what, talk to the headman. So he says, someone took away his pumpkins. So someone took away the pumpkins of the headman. Someone took away the pumpkins of the money lender. And then what happened? Not only the pumpkins, along with the creeper, the pumpkins were taken. So the pumpkins were robbed with the creeper. And he, for some reason, the headman was of the impression that Munni had taken the pumpkin and the creeper. Munni and his goats have taken the pumpkin. So a headman might have thought pumpkin was eaten by Munni and the creeper was made was eaten by the by Munni's goat, or Munni made his goats eat the creeper of the pumpkin. So the, he was of that impression, who the headman. So that's why I never let my goats be seen anywhere near the farm. So Munni is saying that is why I don't allow my goats to go near the farms. I don't want such a complaint for myself as well as for my goats. That's why I don't take them near the farms, he says. Munni says. His eyes travel to his goats, nosing about, attempting to wrest nutrition from minute greenery, peeping out of rock and dry earth. So his eyes, he just looked at his goats, nosing about, isn't it? So the goats were nosing about. They were in those little greenery, whatever was there around the statue, right? Around the statue of the horse. So nosing about, attempting to rest. So what they were doing, they were in search of the little nutrition from those minute greenery peeping, right? So from that minute greenery, so those green foliage around the statue, little greenery, whatever was there. So they were, these goats were in search of that greenery and they were eating it out of rock and dry earth. So out of this dry earth, out of the rock, those little greenery, little foliage, whatever was there, green foliage, they were searching it out, finding it out, those goats, two goats, you know, Munni's, they were grazing, right? So they were searching that little minute, little thing, little green foliage, and they were depending, they were eating it, right? So that he was looking, Munni was looking at the goats, his own goats. The foreigner followed his look and decided that it would be a sound policy to show an interest in the old man's pets. So the foreigner, when Munni looked at the goats, foreigner also looked at the goats. And he felt like it's a tricky way. It's a tricky way just to pamper the pets, isn't it? So there the foreigner felt that this man loves his pets more than anything. Those two goats. Okay. So this old man loves his, he's interested in his goats. So let me show some interest in his goats. So he will be pleased. Who will be pleased? Munni will be pleased. This is what the foreigner felt over here. He went up casually to them and stroked their backs with with every show of courteous attention. So who went very casually? The foreigner went casually to those goats and stroked. So he just moved his hand on their backs, on the goats' backs, with every show of courteous attention. So showing some interest to those goats, he had put his hands on the back of the, he started patting the goats. Now the truth dawned on the old man. His dream of a lifetime was about to be released. Now the truth dawned on the old man. His dream of a lifetime was about to be realized over here. Now the truth dawned on the old man. So here the truth, it struck the old man. Munni came to know what actually the foreigner was intending. That is what Munni was feeling, but you know what the foreigner was intending. I told you earlier, he was intending, his intention was totally of the horse. But here it was, old man felt that he was interested in the goats at this point. His dream of a lifetime was about to be realized. Now he felt like this man was interested in the goats, and there his dream is going to be proved out. That is what Munni felt, isn't it? It's going to be true that if these two goats are sold, he will be getting good amount. 100 rupees is going to get. It's a good amount. That is what Munni felt over here, right? He understood that the red man was actually making an offer for the goats. Now he felt with that 100 rupee note, the red man, the foreigner, was making an offer for the goats. This is what Munni felt over here. He had reared them up in the hope of selling them someday, and with the capital, opening a small shop on this very spot. That was his dream. Okay, that is why he felt that the dream is going to truly happen in his life, and it is going to work out. This is what Munni felt. He had reared them. So he brought these goats up in the hope of, so with the hope that he's going to sell them someday or the other, and with the capital and with the investment, with the amount, whatever is going to get on it, is going to open a small shop, isn't it, on this very spot, same spot over there, is going to open a small shop, and there he's going to sit and is going to do all these business, right? So that was his plan, that was his dream. So at this point, when he was feeling that his dream is going to come true, at this point with that 100 rupees note, he'll be able to open a shop. sitting here watching towards the hills, he had often dreamt how he would put up a thatched roof here, spread a gunny sack out on the ground and display on it fried nuts, colored sweets and green coconut for thirsty and famished wayfarers on the highway, which was sometimes very busy. Okay, so sitting, often he used to sit over there when he, while grazing the goats, he used to dream sitting over there. So watching towards the, sitting here, so he, it was his dream, watching towards the hills, he had often dreamt, when he was watching towards the hills, he used to dream this, how he would put a thatched roof here. Thatched roof, not a a pakka house, not a pakka shop, right? A kacha one, right? So something like that, with the thatched in the sense bamboo sticks, cow dung or sand mixed together, put together, such a roof, or maybe some dry coconut leaves or grass, something on the roof he will put, a temporary shed like thing he is going to put, and he's going to spread a gunny sack on the ground. Gunny sack is the same, the jute sack, isn't it, used for agriculture produce and all that, right? So that is what is gunny sack mentioned over here. So he's going to spread that gunny sack, that jute sack, out on the ground. Normally this is how olden days people used to display their wares, isn't it, for selling. So like that he's going to display his wares on it. Now what are his wares? You can see over here. So he's going to spread out this gunny sack on the ground and display on this gunny sack fried nuts. So these are common things which is easily available in those villages, right? So fried nuts and colored sweets, olden type sweets, small sweets, right? Small items, colored sweets and green coconut. Coconut for the thirsty and famished wayfarers. So coconut, which was extremely meant for those people, those who were very famished in the sense, extremely hungry people, right? Wayfarers means traveler on foot, those who used to walk that side on foot. So for those passers-by, for them, he is going to overcome their thirst, their hunger by selling these type of items on the highway, which was sometimes very busy. Sometimes it used to be very busy and people never used to find any shops like this nearby. And this was his dream of opening such a small shop nearby and wherein he can sell these type of small items just to overcome their hunger or thirst, the passers-by. Okay. The animals were not prize ones for a cattle show, but he had spent his occasional savings to provide them some fancy diet now and then, and they did not look too bad. So these animals were not so fancy, these would have been taken for some cattle show, right? So cattle show, you need some healthy fat, right? So build animals, so they were not so, but whatever little money, whatever little thing he had often spent it. He had often spent this for buying something what was a good diet for his goats. That he had always done, and they did not look too bad also. Because of that, they were not looking very lean. Okay, so today I'll wind it up to here. In the next link, I will be completing the remaining part of the lesson. Till then, thank you very much.